So here we are, finally. We've been for weeks now looking at how we can actually live on earth as it is in heaven right now, right where we are, in any occupation, in any place. And we've been looking at the pattern of heaven, specifically those four dynamics that we see around the throne of God. We see that God's at the center. We see that there are burning ones that are in the place of worship, gazing on the beauty of Jesus. We see that there are 24 elders, and we see that worship never stops. So if you look at the first one, God at the center, I can live today on earth as it is in heaven when I put God at the center and I ruthlessly look at my life, I dethrone idols, I tear down accusations, and I go, God, I'm putting you at the center of my life right now. I can give you what you came for, what you purchased at the cross. You can be at the center. Mm.
Yes, I love the call to be a burning one. Mm. I think it's really the way we were designed, obviously, to live, to be, as we behold him, as we discover who he is. The response is that of a burning heart. And we were made to live wholehearted. I mean, we were made to live where the first commandment really is first place in our lives, where we love him with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength. And just to see in this moment of human history, I feel that invitation coming globally. We're watching as that's the response of the body of Christ to enter into this fellowship of burning hearts where Jesus really is at the center and our hearts are on fire. Yes. Our hearts are alive in him.
Yeah, so God at the center, burning ones, and then the 24 elders, the picture of human beings at the center of the government of God. And the way that that impacts my life today is I realize that through the blood of the Lamb, I've been redeemed to be a king and a priest. I come boldly before the throne of God. I'm not distant. I have bold access. He moves at the sound of my voice, and doesn't matter where I live, my occupation, how little, how big, how small, I get to move heaven today. And he's given us that glory. It's remarkable.
Yeah. And I love how it's the 24/7 reality. Mm. It's the prayer and worship that is unceasing. And just as the Father had shown me the everlasting future, that is what happens in heaven. And that is where this whole thing is going, is unceasing adoration, 24/7, around the clock. It's just what David did with the Tabernacle of David was just this foreshadowing of the glorious, victorious church entering into our identity before the Lord with this unceasing praise, unceasing worship, yes, and adoration.
And I can do that even now, meaning like Paul says, pray without ceasing. Yes. What he says it in Romans 12, offer your bodies up as a living sacrifice of worship. I can do that all day long. I really can live that. And so we have the opportunity. We have an ache in us for the days to come. We have a longing that it would be on the earth as it is in heaven. There would be an increase of his presence. But I am the very dwelling place of God right now. And I can bring heaven to earth by the way that I live my life and reflect heaven. And so for us, living in this hour of human history and just really seeing the nations rage all around us and wrestling with our own ache and weakness in all of it, that's really why 111 exists, is to bring the government of God, to make disciples who train, send laborers, who advance his kingdom in every place. And we do that through these primary principles of living on earth as it is in heaven. And we want to invite you to, even in this season, give, that we could touch cities and nations around the earth, that we could make disciples, that we could shift government through normal people like you and me who live on earth as it is in heaven. There's a link on the page. Even today, I encourage you to give generously, that the nations, that we would shift government, that the church would shift government on earth as it is in heaven. Thank you.